I welcome you all with my respects. In this session, we are going to be discussing about APB protocol, interface construct, clocking block and mod port. In the previous session, we have been declared the ports of APB protocol with logic keyword. And we have seen what is the purpose of the logic keyword and what are the limitations of the logic keyword. When the multiple drivers are driving the signals, we have to use the wire. That's the thing we have been discussed in the previous session. Okay, let me enter into the today's session. In this session, we are going to be declare the clocking block. Clocking block and mod port. One interface construct may contains multiple clocking blocks. Exclusively bus design contains clocking block for master, clocking block for slave, clocking block for the arbiter. Parallelly, we can declare the mod port. First, we will see the clocking block. Clocking block, the syntax of the clocking block look like this: clocking and clocking. Inside the clocking block, we can declare input and output signals. Clocking at clocking space, the name of the clocking block, that is called instance. At inside the parenthesis, we are declaring the clock signal. This is the syntax of the clocking block. Next, we will discuss about mod port. What is mod port? Mod port is the grouping the signal and sending to the monitor. That is the actual operation of the monitor. That is the actual operation of mod port. Okay, mod port which can be declared inside the interface construct. This is the syntax of mod port. Mod port space instance in bracket we have to pass the clocking block, name of the clocking block. In general, bus design contains three mod ports: one for slave, one for master, one for arbiter. Here I have named arbiter as passive. Let us declare the clocking block. First, clocking block for master. Clocking master underscore cb at postage of p clock. Inside, input and output signals declared end clocking. Next, we will declare clocking block for slave. Clocking slave underscore cb at postage of clock. Inside of that clocking block, we can declare input and output. End clocking. Next, we will declare the clocking block for arbiter. Here I have named passive. Next, we will declare the clocking block for monitor. Clocking monitor underscore cb at postage of clock. Inside of the monitor clocking block, I have declared only input signal. Because monitor doesn't have the output, those signals have been declared like this. End clocking. Now we have been finished the declaration of clocking blocks. After declaration of the clocking block, we have to declare the mod port. Already I have stated interface block contains three mod port: one for master, one for slave, another one for arbiter. This is the declaration of mod port. Mod port master in bracket, I have been passed the master clock signal. Inside the parenthesis, I have passed the name instance of the clocking block of slave. Next, mod port, name of the mod port is passive. I have declared this mod port for monitor. In bracket, I have been passed clocking block name of monitor. Been declared the mod port. Now we have completed the declaration part of mod port. That's all. Now we have completed the interface block of APB protocol. Okay, in the next session we will discuss about in code of APB protocol using system Verilog. Thank you.